Good morning. Good morning. Praise God. Welcome to Prophetic Judah International Ministries with your host, Prophetess Jacqueline King. Amen. Today is an awesome day. Today is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Let's be glad. Amen. God has given us another day. He's given us another chance to get our act together. Amen. He's a covenant keeping God. He will keep his promises because he's our Lord. He's a sovereign God. Amen. He's Adonai, the God of sovereignty. Amen. He is the master of our lives. Amen. He is our owner. Amen. Praise God. He claims us. Amen. Praise God. Through our obedience to him, our service to him. Amen. We have a relationship with him. Praise God. So we just give God the highest praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome to Prophetic Judah. Praise God. I will be teaching on the subject, Isaiah 59 verse 19. Praise God. When the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord, praise God, will lift up a standard against him. So that's what I will be teaching. I found this awesome teaching by Kenneth Kahn. Amen. And I love it, and I just wanted to share it with you guys. So in the meantime, while I get all my stuff together, I will be playing us a song of worship, where we could just get into the presence of God and expect something great to happen. Amen. Praise God. Let's expect something great to happen in Jesus' name. Let's go forward.
Just want you. I could search for earthly things to satisfy my every need, but oh God, I just want you. Whoa. Every day, yeah. Lay down my will and all my selfish desires, whatever it takes. Father, that's what I'll do, 'cause I just want you. Oh, yes, I do. Standing in this hole, only here to seek your face. Oh God, I just want you. Can you feel the passion in my heart? I wanna be close to where you are. Oh God, I just want you. Every day,
I just want you.
Amen. Praise God. I just want you, Father. Amen. That's what it's about, having an intimate relationship with our living God. Amen. Just recognizing who He is in our lives, just taking pleasure with Him. You know, it's just like when you meet someone for the first time and they have all the perfect attributes, you know, things that are very appealing, and they attract you to that place where you just hunger for that love, you know. And once they capture your heart, hey, you can't help yourself. You just fall in love and you just begin to worship that person in that particular area. Just saying, thank you for being in my life. Thank you that you see value in me. Thank you for appreciating me. Amen. And that's how it is, you know, when you reverse the role with God and you just take your time and begin to love on Him. You know, just wake up in the morning having that happy, bubbly, goody attitude, you know, just saying, thank you, Father, over to you in the name of Jesus, because this day, Lord, you have made, and I just want to worship you. I just want to be closer to you. I just want to have that that intimate moment with you through your Son, Jesus Christ, and acknowledging that Jesus is Lord. Amen. Jesus is Lord. He is the King of all kings, and that He will provide for us because He is more than enough. Amen. God is more than enough. Praise God. Moving forward, amen, I just want to start teaching on the names of God, recognizing and acknowledging and having reverence for who He is in our lives, amen, and begin to pray more with His name, you know, with the name of name, the name that's above all names, you know, Jesus, amen, praise God, but also using God's name in context and not out of context, just recognizing what He has done in the Old Testament and in the fulfillment of the New Testament. So the Spirit of the Lord really is dealing with me in that area for the past couple of weeks. I did teaching, I think last week, I can't recall, on moving forward and learning how to speak the name of God out loud in all circumstances and situation. And I believe I did Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Jireh, amen. I believe I did Jehovah Shammah, praise God, and Jehovah Rohi, which is Psalms 23, praise God. So there's multiple teachings that I will continue to do, amen. Praise God, including El Shaddai. I did El Shaddai, who is the all-sufficient God, all-bountiful God, amen. The one who fills and makes fruitful and used in connection with judging and chastening and purging and translating, amen. God is almighty. He has the right to judge. He has the right to purge, amen. God has the right to chasten those because He loves us, amen. The word of God say, God chastens the ones He loves, amen. So He is El Shaddai, and praise God. And I'm going to continue to teach on this, amen, until I move to the next level. I'm gonna be doing variety teachings, but I'm focusing on here right now. So I want to talk about the Spirit of the Lord, amen. The Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard, amen. He will raise up a standard, and that scripture comes from Isaiah 59:19. And so let me pray. Praise God. I'm moving real fast, but let me just begin to pray and just welcome the Holy Spirit. Just give God praise and thanks. God, let this be a teaching that will bring breakthrough into people's lives. Amen. I thank you for the author of this teaching, Kenny Khan, that he will continue to spread the gospel of your Son, Jesus Christ, and bring forth liberation through the power of the Holy Spirit, through people's confession that they believe that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. And if you're someone that's listening to this recording right now, you haven't met Jesus as your personal Savior, feel welcome to accept Him. Just say, Father, come into my heart. Father, I believe in your Son, Jesus Christ. I believe He died on the cross for my sins. Amen. I believe that He resurrected. Amen. He was buried and He resurrected on the third day with all power. And I confess Jesus Christ as Lord of my life. Amen. I believe I am free, and who the Son sets free, He is free indeed. And you could go to a house of God, go to church, and you know, let people know that you accepted Jesus Christ in your life, and confess that, amen, before man. Confess before God, before man. Let everybody know you have accepted Jesus as your Lord. Get that affirmation, that reassurance, amen, that Christ lives in you. Amen. And you could go to Romans, the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 9 through verse 10. Amen. And just begin to confess daily, Jesus is Lord of your life. Praise God. So let's just move into the teaching. And let's talk about the word flood. Amen. And it says here, if you check in the Hebrew dictionary for the word flood in Isaiah 59:19, you will realize that you are not talking about the enemy's flood that tried to destroy us. But instead, it's God's flood that sweeps away the enemy and his works. Amen. And that's one of the things, that's what really caught me with this teaching, was because it says in the word of God, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord would lift up a standard against him. So when I looked at this teaching, I did my research. The flood in reference is talking about God's flood. God will raise up a standard. Amen. God will sweep away the enemy's devices, the enemy's tricks. Amen. And one thing we have to be aware of, that the enemy is doing the same thing as he did in the Garden of Eden up to right now. Amen. But what's happening is that we're losing a generation of people who are not living by the standards of God. Amen. They know of the Bible. They know of the scriptures, but there's no intimacy with God. And when you have that intimacy with God, God will give you revelation concerning his scripture, such as the flood. Amen. So when we see that when the enemy comes in like a flood, amen, God will lift up a standard. God's presence, his spirit, will lift up a standard that will destroy, amen, the enemy, that will sweep away the enemy and his works. Amen. We have to remember the adversary is Satan. And Satan, amen, comes with wicked devices. That's why the word of God tells us that we must be aware of the plans of the enemy. Amen. In Ephesians chapter 6, praise God. It says here the word flood, which means Nahar in Hebrew. It means great waters. God's running waters. It can also mean prosperity, sparkle, cheerful. So when the enemy tries to come in and attack us or swarm us, like a Nahar, like a flood, God will lift up a standard against him, put into flight and chase them away. Amen. So God is going to lift up a standard. God is going to chase your enemies. Amen. He's going to get rid of them. Nahar. Mm-hmm. Nahar. Great waters. Rushing waters. Amen. God is going to come in and he's going to cause prosperity. He's going to cause sparkle. Cheerful. Amen. Because one thing the enemy wants to do, according to John 10:10, he wants to kill, steal, and destroy. So he comes in like a flood, but God raises up a standard. Amen. He chases him away. God will put 1,000 to flight. Amen. He will cause your enemies to scatter. Amen. Praise God. That awesome God. Amen. Praise God. So who is your enemy? Well, I just said it. Satan. Satan. Satan is our enemy. He is our adversary. Amen. He's the one that works in the powers of darkness. Amen. He's the one who does not want us to prosper in God. And I just love that scripture about the living waters, that God would give us living waters. Amen. He will fill us up until our cup runneth over. It says that out of our belly will flow living waters. It will be bubbly, bubbly. You know, I said that in my last teaching. And here you can see Nahar, that the presence of God comes in like a flood. The presence of God comes in like a flood. Why? Because he's going to wash away the devices of the enemy. He's going to destroy their plans. Amen. Their assignments that they have against you. And that's why it's so important to know who and what you are dealing with. But the only way you're going to have that knowledge, you got to be in the word of God. Amen. Psalms 90 verse 5. Amen. Psalms 91, the things I really don't like to just do halfway teaching on scriptures. So I like to start at verse 1, then I'm going to go away to verse 5. Amen. And it says right here, Lord, you have been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, or ever you had formed the earth and the world. Amen. Even from everlasting to everlasting, you are God. You turn man to destruction and return. O children of men, for 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past. And like a watch in the night, you carry them away like a flood. They are like a sleep in the morning, and they are like grass which grows up. Amen. And they, in one scripture, it talks about how God renews us. You know, we get renewed in our sleep. Amen. It talks about how God comes in and sweeps away the enemy. Praise God. And it talks about he will carry them away like a flood. And that's what God, while you're sleeping, God will come in like a flood. And he's going to drive out the enemy's forces while you sleep. And I want to make emphasis on that, because there are so many people that are struggling with their sleep. And so if you want to, you can use Isaiah 59, amen, verse 19, as a prayer point, and ask God to raise up a standard around you while you sleep. Amen. Pray and remind God that how he said, when the enemy comes in like a flood, amen, and when God comes in, amen, he's going to raise up that standard. Amen. So pray that God will raise up a standard when the enemy's trying to plant evil devices in your home, in your sleep, even with your children. Pray that word over your children too. Amen. And let the flowing waters of God begin to come in and just cleanse your environment while you sleep. Amen. Because God is like a mighty water, rushing water. He's going to come in and he's going to overflow. Amen. He's going to bring destruction to the enemy. Amen. Especially the ones that's trying to overpower us when we are sleeping. Amen. Those night spirits that likes to come in and cause havoc, come in to harass us, come in and torment us. Amen. Just pray that the Spirit of the Lord will raise up a standard, because God is almighty. He's a mighty one. Amen. He is the strong one. Amen. He is strong. Amen. You have to admit the power of God in your life daily. God is strong. The power of his Holy Spirit has come upon us. Amen. Just like it says in the book of Acts chapter 1, verse 8. It says right here, it came to pass when we shall receive power, when the Holy Spirit has come upon us. Amen. And the Spirit of God will lift up a standard. Amen. Against the enemy and its works. Amen. Amen. Jehovah NISSI. That's where I'm coming from today. I'm talking about Jehovah NISSI. When the enemy comes in like a flood, God will raise up a standard. He will raise up the banner. Amen. Because he is Jehovah NISSI. God will destroy the works of the enemy. Amen. That's coming to attack you. Amen. Let's go there. It says in Exodus 17 verse 15. And it talks about Joshua, amen, how Joshua went forth against Amalek, amen, and Moses, Aaron, and Ur went up on top of the hill. So it came about when Moses held his hand up that Israel prevailed, and when he let his hand down, Amalek prevailed. So I want to tell you today, keep your hands up. It's so important to raise your hands up to worship. Mm-hmm. It's so important to keep your hands up during prayer. You know, it's how you choose. It's what you choose. But just know that God is Jehovah NISSI. God can change your situation for your good. Amen. What the enemy meant for your bad, God will change it. Just like how the enemy thought they could destroy the children of Israel, they couldn't. Why? Because Jehovah NISSI, Jehovah my banner, stood up, amen, over the Amalek, amen, and destroyed every one of them. Amen. Praise God. He destroyed every one of them. Why? Because Aaron and Ur supported the hands of Moses while the enemy was pursuing the children of Israel. Moses held his hands up and the Spirit of the Lord came in and raised the standard. Jehovah NISSI came in and the children of Israel won their battle. Amen. Praise God. Do you have a battle in your life that needs to be won? Amen. Is there someone or something or whatever needs to be defeated in your life? Go to Jehovah NISSI. Amen. Go to the Lord, our who is our banner. Amen. Go to him. Amen. Praise God. God will set a standard, amen, in your life against your enemies, those who feel they could come and defeat you. Amen. God will set the record straight with those that comes to pursue you. Amen. But you have to raise your hands up and believe in God. He is the banner, the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Has been given to us. Amen. As a church, we are to commune with the Holy Spirit. We are to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit, not with the enemy. How can we triumph? The enemy have triumph, have victory, if we're not in relationship with God? How do we expect the Spirit of the Lord to come in and raise up a standard for us if we're not in relationship with Him on a continuous basis? Jehovah Nissi wants to fellowship with us, amen. Jehovah Nissi wants to raise up a standard for us, amen. And right now, I'm praying that God will raise up intercessors, many intercessors who will pray in the Spirit and pray in truth, amen. Who will come to the forefront, amen, and begin to raise up a standard, amen. Begin to allow Jehovah Nissi to come in, amen, and that let the Spirit of Nahar come in, and God will flood out our enemies, amen. He will cause our enemies to scatter in the name of Jesus, amen. We thank God, amen. Therefore, there's no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, because we are not in condemnation. We are not in condemnation, so we have the right to win our battery, win our war, amen. Win the battles, amen, that is in our way, that's causing havoc and destruction. Call on Jehovah Nissi. Call on the name of our living God. Raise up a standard by raising up your hands and calling on His name. Amen. Begin to praise Him. Amen. Begin to worship Him. Amen. Begin to rally around Him. Amen. Call on His name. Amen. Raise your hands up. Amen. Because God has given you the victory today. Amen. God has given you the victory today. Over to you, Father, in the name of Jesus. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. We thank you, Father God. We praise you, Father, Abba Father. You are Jehovah Nissi. You are the Lord, our banner. Amen. We give you the praises, Father God. We thank you, Father God, that you have control over everything, Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father God, that you are our refuge. You are the God that we dwell in. Amen. I thank you, Father God, no evil shall befall us, no plague, no diseases shall come nigh to our dwelling. For God, you said you will raise up a standard against the enemy. Amen. I give you the praises, God. I give you thanks, Father God. I give you the honor, Father God. I declare your loving kindness this morning, Father God. I declare your loving kindness, God, because you are faithful to us even in the night hour. And I thank you, Father God. I glorify you. I thank you, Father God, because I know your name, Father God. Because I know you, I can call upon you, Father God. And you will answer me, Father God. Even in my trouble, you will be there to deliver me and honor me, Father God. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father God. We just give you the praises. Come on, come on. Just lift up the standard. Just begin to worship God. Just begin to worship Him, because He is Jehovah Nissi. Amen. Begin to celebrate His name. Begin to celebrate His presence in your life. Amen. Trust God. Believe in God. He is the God of our salvation. He is the God of our deliverance. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. We just give God the praises right now. Thank you, Father. We just thank you. We worship you, Father God, in the name of Jesus.
God, I want to be the place where you live, Jesus. Stand in awe of your presence, the beauty of your righteousness. We need a touch from your grace, and here the chains must fall at the power of your word. And here the chains must fall at the power of your word. Right here in this moment, the chains must fall at the power of your word. And every knee must bow and tongue confess that Jesus is Lord. And this shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise. This shall be called the place of Bethel, the place where God lives. Somebody sing it to him. This shall be called the house of worship. This shall be called the place of praise.
This shall be called the place of Bethel.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Command the spirit of worship to come upon your life. Command his presence. Amen. To come upon your life. Amen. To shake away the dross in your life. Amen. To remove all sin in your life. Amen. Command your soul to worship, worship, worship. Raise up your hands. Amen. Let the spirit of the Lord come in right now to raise up a standard against your enemies. Amen. Let the spirit of Nahor come in right now and flood your atmosphere with your worship. Amen. Begin to trust God in everything that he say he is going to do for you. Amen. Put your trust in God because he loves you and he loves me. Amen. Praise God. I'm going to use some prayer points right now. For the sake of time, I'm just going to go ahead and start interceding for you guys who are listening. Amen. Whether you're a child of God or not, you still need prayer. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. And you have the opportunity again to give your life to Christ if you believe and confess with your mouth. Amen. And believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. Believe that he is the Son of God. Believe that he could change your life around. Amen. According to Romans chapter 10, verse 9 through verse 10. Amen. Romans 10:10. Just confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord. Confess your sins. Ask him to wash him and cleanse you from all of your iniquities. In Jesus' name. Amen. On the prayer points that I'm going to be using is Psalms 28. Hebrews 4 verse 15, but my favorite verse is verse 12. So if you want, you can read verse 12, 13, and 14 and 15. Amen. Praise God. And I will be reading prayer points Psalms 18 through verse 46 and verse 50. And like I used earlier, Psalms 91, amen. And Proverbs 1:33. So I'm going to be using various prayer points, but I just want you to know what I'm praying and what scriptures I'm coming from, including Ephesians 6 through verse 13. Verse 13 through verse 18. Praise God. Amen. And I'm praying for your safety and your protection. Amen. And the title of this message is Jehovah NISSI, Isaiah 59 verse 19. So let's begin to get into the presence of God. Command your spirit to worship. Amen. Command your spirit to worship. Pull on God. Rejoice. Amen. And one thing about it, when you pray, always rejoice in God. Always pray and with rejoicing. Praise God. Because the prayer has already been answered. If you just go to Hebrews 4 verse 12, the word is quick, is sharp. The word is discerner. The word moves. Amen. Praise God. It changes the foundations of the earth. Amen. Because God is a creator. He is the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Psalms 28. To you I will cry, O Lord, my rock. Do not be silent to me. Lest if you are silent to me, I become like those who go down to the pit. Hear the voice of my supplications. Hear the voice of my supplications when I cry to you, when I lift up my hands towards your holy sanctuary. Do not take me away with the wicked, with the workers of iniquity, who speaks peace to their neighbors, but evil in their hearts. Give them according to their deeds and according to the wickedness of their endeavors. Give them according to the work of their hands. Render to them what they deserve, because they do not regard the works of the Lord, nor the operation of his hands. He shall destroy them and not build them up. Blessed be the Lord. Blessed be the Lord, because he has heard the voice of my supplications. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and I am helped. Therefore, my heart greatly rejoices, and with my song I will praise him. The Lord is their strength, and he is the saving refuge of his anointed. Amen. Save your people, bless your inheritance, shepherd them also, and bear them up forever. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Over to you, Father God. Lord, Father God, I thank you. You are my rock. I thank you, Father God, you are not silent. Amen. I thank you, Father God, I will not go down to the pit. And I thank you, Lord, that you hear my supplications. I raise my hands up to you right now, God, towards your holy sanctuary. I thank you, Father God, that the wicked shall not prosper. Amen. They are defeated, Father God, in the name of Jesus, God. God, because you will give them according to their wickedness and their endeavors, Father God. You will render back to them what they have done to me, Father God, because your words say so. I thank you, Father God, that you will not, they do not regard you, Father God, nor your works, Father God, nor the operation of your hands, Father God. So you, Father God, you shall destroy them, Father God, and you will not build them up again. Lord, I bless your name right now, God. I thank you for your word, God. I thank you, Lord, you are my strength. I thank you, Lord, you are my refuge. I thank you, Father God, that you saved me. You saved those who heed to your word. For we are blessed, Father God, for we have inherited your inheritance through Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you, Father God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Father, I thank you for your protection right now, for those who are listening, for those who I'm interceding for right now. God, I thank you for your protection right now over them. Amen. And I pray, Lord, for hearing my prayer and answering my prayers in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord. Whoever's listening right now, you are working in their lives right now, God, because you are the blessed rock. Amen. You are the blessed rock. You are our rock, Father God. And we exalt you, Father God, because you are the God of our salvation in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you execute vengeance for them, Father God, who are listening. Mm-hmm. Whoever's troubling you right now, just know that God is executing vengeance for you. Amen. I praise you that God has delivered you from your enemies. Amen. God has delivered you from your enemies. Whoever you are who's listening, just know today God has delivered you from your enemies. God has lifted you up above them. God has raised you up against them. Amen. Because the Spirit of the Lord, amen, comes in like a flood. Amen. Praise God. Nahar, he will come in like a flood. He will wash away the devices of the enemy. Amen. He will wash away their plans. Amen. He will wash away their wickedness. Amen. Because he is a God. He is the God of Jehovah. He is Jehovah Nissi, the God, our banner. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. He will cause your enemies to scatter. Amen. We send praises to your name, Father God. We thank you for your great deliverance, Father God. We thank you, Lord, that you are showing us your loving kindness. Amen. Especially to your anointed ones. Amen. Praise God. Especially to the anointed ones, even to our children's children. In the name of Jesus. We praise you, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for all things through Christ Jesus. We give you the glory. We give you the honor. We thank you for protection. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Praise God. We thank God. Amen. We thank God for the lesson. We thank God that he is our banner. Amen. He is our El Shaddai, amen, the all-sufficient, bountiful God, amen. He is our Adonai, amen. He is the master of our lives, amen. He is Jehovah God. He is self-existent, omnipotent God, unchangeable God, amen. He is a self-existent God. He's a God of revelation. He is a God of understanding. He is a God of wisdom. He is a God of knowledge. Hey! Give praise and thanks. Amen. Give praise and thanks. You're serving an almighty God. You're serving a God of love, a God of righteousness, a God of peace, a God of joy. Amen. Count it all joy that you are serving a living God. Amen. He is a discerner. Amen. Praise God. He knows what he's doing for you. Amen. Give Jehovah praises. Amen. Express your joy and your love to him. Express your love and your joy to him. Amen. Praise God. He is El Elyon. Amen. Praise God. He is Almighty God. He is an almighty God. Hey, he is a great, dreadful God. He is a God who will keep his promises to his people. He is a promise keeper. Amen. Start rejoicing. Amen. Start rejoicing. Give God the praises no matter how hard it gets. He said he would come in like a flood and he would destroy the works of your enemies. Amen. Praise God. Rejoice in God. He has answered your prayers. And I will continue to intercede for you as the Spirit of the Lord leads me. Amen. I will continue to do what God has called me to do because I'm just in love with him. Amen. I'm just in love with God. He's an awesome God and I wouldn't have it any other way. Amen. Amen.
Lift your worship now. Find favor in your sight, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are, across the hottest desert. I'll try.
Wanna be where you are.
Gotta be
where you are.